Hi, I'm Clarence Hill, and this is the Goshen 10. I'm often asked, what is Goshen? Goshen is the land that the children of Israel lived in Egypt. The story about the children of Israel in Egypt goes like this. Joseph was the 11th brother of the children of Israel, and he was sold into slavery into Egypt. Well, he was a slave, then he was a prisoner, then God raised him up to be the second to Pharaoh in the nation of Egypt. So when the famine hit, he was promoted and he was able to provide a place of safety for the children of Israel. And so he told the children of Israel that you'll dwell in this land, you and your children and your children's children. Well, years later, when Moses was raised up because a Pharaoh rose up that didn't know Joseph, he put all the children of Israel into bondage. And that's what brought on Moses. So when Moses comes on the scene, God calls him and tells him that I'm going to send you down to deliver the children of Israel. Well, during that time, he caused judgments to fall on the children of all of Egypt. And the Pharaoh continued to harden his heart for 10 different plagues. Well, finally, the Pharaoh let them go. But during the time that those judgments fell, the children of Israel were also in Egypt. But they were in the best land called the land of Goshen. And during the time that the judgments came down, the judgments hit the Egyptians, but they did not hit the children of Israel. So Goshen for us today represents that today God is bringing judgments on America in two distinct areas. One is in the area of our economics, and the other one is in the elements. Winds, floods, tornadoes, hurricanes, these we'll see on a more increasing level. But what he's calling on from us is that we would not be judged with those that don't follow God's principles. So the Goshen 10 tells us what principles, what commands, what things that we should be doing anyway, not just to prepare for crisis time, but these are principles that we should do anyway so that we can be following God's principles concerning money, concerning caring for each other, concerning being attentive to our families, concerning health, and all of the other things that are mentioned in the Goshen 10. So, spiritual obedience, being obedient to God and following His ways, is to dwell in the land of Goshen, so that when our economy is shaken because you're debt free, you're not toppled when the economy crumbles. And that when you have a need for medical things, it doesn't come up as much because you have health, because you have peace in your life. And the scripture says you get righteousness and peace and joy when you receive the Holy Spirit. So that's righteousness, that's called doing right, following God's ways, that produces peace. And peace, another term for peace, is health. And those things will prosper in your life when you follow God's ways. So that's the story behind Goshen. So let me invite you to the land of Goshen, where we obey God and find the things that we ought to be doing anyway in the Goshen 10. I'm Clarence Hill, and this is the Goshen 10.